Hi, Chris. Talking today after a disappointing first home game of the 23-24 season. Complete reversal of the last time we played Bromsgrove, and we beat 4-0 on the last game of the season here. And on the wrong end of a 4-0 drubbing today.
Yeah. Yeah, there's not much to say past that nil, really. I think the frustrating thing is I know we're putting together a talented group, and what we've said to them in this first sort of few weeks of the season, the most important thing is performance. Now, I spoke last week and I held my hand up about the way we went about the first half last week, and I've said to the boys in there that I'll stand by them. But first half was, the output was nowhere near good enough for Royston Town. And they've been left with that. Now, we've had a go second half. Huffed and puffed a little bit, some moments, but we've been working on things, and it was, on my watch, it was 41 minutes, 52 seconds before I actually saw like a pattern of play that we'd worked on. So that comes down to understanding of each other, bravery, and wanting to get on the football and influence a game of football. And that's where I'm not happy with things in terms of the first half. Second half, listen, we've had a go, a couple of errors have let them in and they've been more clinical. We've had our chances, we haven't been. But I don't feel that we've given a true reflection on what we've been working on and building towards, and that was what is important. The guys have had a tough time down here fans-wise over the last couple of seasons. And what I'd say is that they're an honest group of lads. We're a group that are working hard, and it hasn't happened today at all. There's some honest mistakes for the goals. First one maybe not so, but it's got to be better now. There's no sugarcoating it. It's got to be better.
Yeah, and the game's obviously coming thick and fast Tuesday night. Stamford here, that's a perfect opportunity to, put that right to some degree, really.
Yeah. I mean, that's a blessing. The last thing I'd want is another week. I don't think I could handle another week mentally without another game. So we have to get back on the horse on Tuesday, and we have to show that it's a blip and show that we are working towards positive things. They will get the backing 100% as a group. They've got to be braver. And that's probably where I'm disappointed. I don't think there was enough moments in the first half where we were brave, and then we spoke about it at half-time. And then throughout the full 90 minutes, I don't think we've given the guys that have come down to watch enough moments to enjoy. So, it is what it is. We can't do anything about it now. There needs to be a lot of food and thought that goes. Sorry, a lot of food for thought. But I'm trying to find positives now. I think young Ange making his home debut for a young man. I thought he stood up and was counted. But I think collectively we've got to, if we're working on a specific way of playing, we've got to hold our hand up and say, look, that's what we are this year. We'll do it by hook or by crook. I just can't back people not wanting the football, and that's what probably needs to be addressed for Tuesday.
And hopefully we'll get a decent sized gate down here, and the boys can put on a performance.
I mean, like I say, it's a good opportunity to jump straight back on it, and that's not going to be an easy game. I don't know any results today, so I don't know how they've got on, but I know their sides are always vibrant and hard working and get at you, and we've got to match that come Tuesday night. So they're hurting in there. I think everyone is, but I know the boys in there are hurting. I know it matters, and like I say, I just have to put it down to the fact that rabbit in headlights maybe. And I think there may have been a sense of, because we played so well second half Telford, that they just needed to show up today. And I think that's a harsh bump to reality, that we're at this level of football for a reason. And as we said before the game, the score's 0-0, and we have to respect that. And I don't think that maybe we did enough. So, like I say, there's not a massive concern in terms of like wrong personnel in the building. I've made no secret that we're missing a couple, and we're still searching for those. But I just think that too many had an off day, and not many stood up and was counted for now.
Okay, let's hope they put it right on Tuesday.
Yeah, fingers crossed.
Cheers, mate.
Cheers, mate.